This is Jeff at Zoller Pump Company at the Center for Excellence in Louisville, Kentucky. In this video, we're going to look at the APAC Indoor High Water Alarm and how to connect it to your Wi-Fi and to the Z-Control Cloud. There's three main steps in connecting the APAC to your account in the cloud. Number one is to connect the APAC to your Wi-Fi in your house. Number two is to either create or log into your cloud account. And number three is to add the device to your account. The first step in connecting your APAC alarm to your Z-Control cloud account is to connect the APAC to your existing Wi-Fi in the house. Now to do that, you have to know what the Z-Control LED is telling you. When it's on solid, that means it's connected to your router and to the cloud, and there's nothing further you need to do. Every once in a while, it'll flicker, and that just indicates that it's communicating with the cloud. The second status of that LED is that it's blinking. When it's blinking, that's indicating that it's trying to connect to your existing router. And then the third status is that that LED is off. Now to start the process, that's what we want. We want the LED to be off. So if your LED is either blinking or it's on and you know it's not connected, what you want to do is you want to just reset it so that we're starting from a fresh starting point. And you just do that by pulling the power out and then press and hold the silence button while plugging in the AC power barrel adapter. Then let go after 3 seconds. You'll see the LED go off. And what that means is that the APAC will now once again be broadcasting its what's called SSID, or in AP mode. Now that the APAC's Z-Control LED is off and it's broadcasting its name, we're gonna go and connect to the APAC and get it online. So first we're going to open the computer or mobile device's list of Wi-Fi connections. Here you'll select the one called APAC underscore and then there's 4 digits. After you select it on a mobile device, a Wi-Fi setup screen will appear. If you've connected to the APAC but the setup screen has not appeared, you may need to open a browser and type either zconfig.com or 192.168.125.1. Either of these addresses will bring up the Wi-Fi setup screen. On this screen, you can select which Wi-Fi you want the APAC to use. Select the Wi-Fi name that you want the APAC to use for its internet connection. Enter the password, and the APAC, using its built-in Wi-Fi, will connect and the Z-Control LED will turn solid. If the attempt to connect the APAC to the router is unsuccessful, and you want to try again, reset the APAC so that it starts broadcasting its SSID again. Perform a reset by either holding the silence button for a full 12 seconds or hold the silence button while plugging in the AC barrel to the side of the APAC. Then let go after 3 seconds. Now that your APAC is connected to the cloud, we're going to add the APAC to your account. First, log in or create an account at zcontrolcloud.com. Next to the location of your choice, click the gear and select Add New Device. If you're using the same Wi-Fi as the APAC is, then you'll be able to choose Auto to add the APAC to your account. If not, choose the manual selection to add the APAC by entering the 13-digit device ID. The website may prompt you to press the silence button to confirm you own the APAC. When complete, the device's Z-Control tile will appear in your account. You may need to refresh the page to see it. Click the View button in the middle of the device's tile. Here you can change preferences for your alarm, including choosing which alarms you want to receive. The hamburger menu in the upper right corner allows you to add contact phone numbers and email addresses for receiving notifications. There's other info, such as general status data, notification history, and the ability to change certain equipment behavior. The Z-Control mobile app is not to be used for setting the devices up onto Wi-Fi or for changing configuration settings. Future updates of the app may include these features. The app can be installed on both Apple and Android devices. This gives you access to your Z-Control enabled products, enables you to see the status, silence alarms, and reset alarms, view the activity, or otherwise known as history, and you can see device details. And you can look at the various locations that you have set up. So in this video, we've learned how to connect APAC to the cloud and add the device to your account. If you have other questions or want to see other videos related to APAC, visit zollerpumps.com.